So I want to talk about operations research analysts in this video. If you don't know who I am Professor Dave Masek. I'm an associate professor of innovation strategy and entrepreneurship. And I actually did a lot of management science and operations research in my undergrad. That was part of a big focus that they had at the institution I went to. I went to the University of Waterloo. They actually have a management science department. I did a lot of my management courses within that particular domain. So I have a good sense of what you actually do and where the career goes with operations research. So it's basically a really quantitative look at industrial operations. That's really to think of the way that you think about it. And you're going to use like different algorithms and different ways to sort of see the world that is very much mathematical and very much focused on optimization and thinking about how to optimize the overall sort of, whether it's a plant or, an industrial problem that you would be working on. And even if you did a PhD in a particular area, you'd probably actually get a, operations analyst degree right when you actually started, or you did a master's degree and you would go into sort of an analyst career, and it would be very it's actually quite lucrative as a career, and it's a nice way to go into industry because you're applying some of the quantitative skills that you actually use, and you probably expect somewhere around the $100,000 range as a starting salary of once you actually get out, somewhere around that kind of range, right? 90, 100, 110, maybe a little more, maybe a little less, but you're basically using quantitative skills to solve operations problems. And what is operations? It's really thinking about the day-to-day of how things actually work and sort of solving, whether it's on the manufacturing floor, the problems that are going on the manufacturing floor, or, solving some bigger problem. And so what you'd actually work for, big corporations like Amazon, for example, they have a lot of problems that they need to solve that are very much just optimization problems. And, Amazon would be a very big employer of this kind of skill set. Right, they would actually look for something like that because all of their problems, the way that they actually treat the world, is very analytical and it's very quantitative. And so they're looking at, okay, how do we sort of simplify the process and make sure that we actually get something done in a very efficient manner? And so they're going to constantly be focusing on reducing all of the extra, costs or extra sort of steps of getting something done. And you're really thinking about the overall operations of how something might happen. You might even do things like machine learning within the particular domain, right? So they cover a lot of different things, and it's actually quite a lucrative career and an interesting career in terms of using quantitative skills, right? And using some of the things that you learn both within a, an undergrad, a master's or a PhD level, where you would understand how optimization actually works. And so I'd actually recommend that's probably a little bit more advanced an engineering type position. It's like industrial engineering. It's very close to some of, the stuff that you do in industrial engineering or process engineering, where you're thinking about like, how do you actually accomplish this thing and get this thing done in the most efficient manner so it actually becomes a product at the end of it and you've reduced your costs? And so it's looking at, from start to finish of actually making something or doing something. It's just doing something. How do you get from start to finish in the most efficient way and the most cost-effective way? But also thinking, how do you maximize profitability in that particular scenario? Now, there are a lot of things that is missing that I think is somewhat problematic that you would never actually understand unless you did maybe an MBA or something like that. And that is kind of the softer skills. That part of it is very much missing. And there is a lot of soft skills that you actually need to understand, like organizational behavior or working with people, for example. You know, another thing that you would fail to realize is things like design, right? Like product design actually matters in terms of getting something done. It's not only how quickly you get things done, but it's also creating something that people actually like. And then also having really deep philosophical questions that you would never cover about, like, is this the right goal that we're trying to optimize on? That's a really big problem that people forget about, right? Like, you can optimize on something and get it done as quickly as possible, but then you realize, like, wait a minute, this is not the ultimate goal. And that's something that you would maybe cover in sort of more in a strategy sense, or, you know, more in a bigger picture. Even sort of philosophy grads would do really well at this, right? That you'd sort of think about, like, what am I actually doing here? Does this actually make sense? Should I be doing this? And those questions are very deep and profound that you would not necessarily cover in something like in operations research. It actually has, you know, the bigger perspective that matters and sort of changes things a lot. So thinking about those skills as well as on the operation side of thinking about, like, how do you do some of these things, right? So somebody might come up with a big picture, but then you have no clue on how to actually create this thing from start to finish, right? And that's where you would need somebody that has understanding of operations, right, from start to finish, and thinking about, like, what part is it that's actually the most problematic that we need to fix and sort of make it as efficient as possible. And then you would use, you know, that's where you would learn a lot of sort of mathematical optimization techniques and things like that to solve these sort of harder problems. They're very difficult to solve. And often you need what are called numerical methods. That these numerical methods, it means that, you know, you can't solve these things as you would in sort of mathematics. There's no right solution. You come up with the best possible solution with what you're actually given, and you do that what's called empirically, where you kind of guesstimate and you get close enough to what the best possible solution is. There's often not a best possible solution, and you just have to sort of guess, and you kind of put your finger in the air what you should actually do based on some real, you know, hardcore facts. And then you actually do get a better result by doing that. So with that, hopefully this helps with operations research analyst. I would recommend that you actually think about that in terms of where you want to go, because a lot of the skills that you might learn in, you know, during a PhD or, you know, quantitative math master's or quantitative undergraduate degree actually are quite applicable in that particular domain. All right, with that, give me a thumbs up.